Calculating least common denominator, LCD, by division. You can think of it as a box method. Least common denominator is the smallest whole number that can be evenly divided by each of the given denominators. Now, the smallest number that can be evenly divisible by 6 and 9 at the same time is 18. Now, 6 will go into 18 three times, and 9 will go into 18 two times. If you only take 6 and 9 and you multiply them, which will give you 54, this will give you a common denominator. But it is not least common denominator. Least common denominator is the smallest number that can be divided by 6 and 9. 54 is a common multiple of 6 and 9 and can be divided by 6 and 9 at the same time, but it's not the smallest number. Let's find least common denominator of 18 and 27 by division. So first thing you want to do is rewrite 18 and 27 somewhere on the side. You want to fence it off with something that resembles a fence or a box and leave some room under the numbers. Next, you want to put division sign, and on this step you want to pick a number. It doesn't have to be the largest number, but a number that is not 1 but will go into 18 and 27 at the same time. Well, I know that 3 will go into 18 and 27 at the same time. So we have 3. 18 divided by 3 will produce a 6. 27 divided by 3 will produce a 9. Here we have 6 and 9, and I know that both of them can be divided by 3. Whatever goes in denominators, you want to put it on the outside. 6 divided by 3 will reduce into 2. 9 divided by 3 will reduce into 3. Now, once you have no more numbers except 1 that will go into whatever you're reducing, you can stop. So, with this box method, once you're done reducing, so you take all the numbers that are on the outside and you multiply them. So least common denominator is 3 times 3 times 2 times 3 again, which is equal to 54. To check, you want to take 54 and divide by 18, and 54 and divide by 27. 54 divided by 18 gives us a 3. 54 divided by 27 gives us a 2. These two numbers we will work with later when we have to add and subtract fractions. But for right now, we just check that 18 and 27 go into 54 whole number of times. So what happens if we have three numbers? So let's say we have 1/12, 1/15, and 1/30. So we have 12, 15, and 30. You can pick a number that goes into all three of them at the same time, or at least two of them at the same time. Now there is divisibility test by 3, which is if you add digits of the number and they are divisible by 3, you can divide by 3. So 1 plus 2 gives me 3, I can divide by 3. 1 plus 5 gives me 6, I can divide by 3. And 3 plus 0 is also 3, so I can divide by 3. So for my first reduction, I will use 3. 3 goes into 12 4 times, 3 goes into 15 5 times, and 3 goes into 30 10 times. So we have 4, 5, and 10. Now there is no number that will go into all of them at the same time, but I know that 4 and 10 both can be divided by 2. Whatever goes in denominators goes on the outside. First fraction will reduce into 2, then we have 5, and then we have another 5. Now, 2 and 5 cannot be divided by a common number except 1, but we can divide both 5s by 5. 2, 5 goes into 5 1 times, 5 goes into 5 1 times. In this problem, least common denominator will be 3 times 2 times 5 times 2, which is 60. If you wish to check, just divide 60 by each of the denominators, just to make sure all of them go into 60 evenly. 30 will go into 60 2 times, 15 will go into 60 4 times, and 12 will go into 60 5 times. Okay, let's try again. We have 1 half, 1 18th, and 1 30th. So we have 2, 18, and 30. 2, 18, and 30 are all even, so each of them can be divided by 2. Whatever goes in denominators, we're going to put on the outside. 2 and 2 will reduce into 1. 2 goes into 18 9 times. 2 goes into 30 15 times. 9 and 15 both can be reduced by 3. 3 goes into 9 3 times. 3 goes into 15 5 times. So least common denominator is 2 times 3 times 3 times 5. If you notice, I do not write times 1 because multiplying by 1 changes nothing. So least common denominator ends up being 90. To check, we have 90 divided by 30, 90 divided by 18, and 90 divided by 2. So we have 3, 5, and 45. One more example. So we have 6, 3, 12. 6, 3, and 12 all can be divided by 3. We have 2, 1, 4 left over. It is very important that you do not stop here because 2 and 4 can be both divided by 2. So we have 1, 1, 2. And the least common denominator will be 3 times 2 times 2, which is 12. We have 12 out of 12, 12 out of 3, and 12 out of 6. This one will reduce into 1 whole, this one will reduce into 4, and this one is 2. That's all.